Oh, hello. My name is Mara, and welcome to Books Like Woe. I come to you today with a video that I don't know if anybody besides me will care about, but I don't know, guys. I just had this moment. I was looking through all of my plans for the year, all of my reading goals, and like, usually what I do is I have my year-long lists and then I go through each month at the beginning and figure out like, okay, you know, I have these arcs that I need to read this month because they're coming out the following month. I have these three challenges I'm working on. So, okay, you know, I need two books from this challenge, a book from this one, like all of that. And then any additional other obligations I may have, like if I'm in some sort of buddy read or a book club or whatever. I did that again at the beginning of June, and I'm not even feeling that overwhelmed by reading right now. I'm not in a reading slump, but I've been looking at it and I just realized I need to change my approach, at least right now, because I don't know. Sorry, I've got this blanket behind me. My kitty cat just woke up, so I was moving some things around. I feel like something is a little bit off right now in terms of how driven by those plans I made at the beginning of the year my current reading is. So instead of doing a TBR, I feel like I'm almost doing like an anti-TBR right now. And I should also say, before we get into some of the things I wanted to talk about, like, I totally get that some people don't do TBRs at all. They think it's dumb or silly, or they just generally like don't really understand why people do challenges or whatever. Like, I get that it's not for everyone. What I have found for myself is that I am quite a mood reader. And sometimes what happens is when I let my mood be the only thing that dictates my reading, either I can kind of get stuck in a rut. Like, I'm somebody who can just get like hyper focused on a genre without any, you know, outside impetus. You know, I've had times where all I wanted to read were mysteries, which is fine, but like, especially as a channel or as somebody who reviews and also who has arcs that they need to be reviewing, that just isn't quite like what I need to be doing for my reading, because it's not just reading for me, it's also reading for other people, which maybe we can also talk about. So to that end, that can be part of what happens when I overly mood read, or I can get so in my own head about like, what am I in the mood to read, that I just don't read. Like, I can't figure out what mood I'm in, and therefore I decide I have no mood and then I don't read. So I have found over the years that having challenges, having not a strict TBR each month, but like a guiding list of things that I would like to read, has been very helpful to me to guide my mood reading, to make sure that I'm, you know, mixing it up, that I'm getting to all of my obligations in terms of things that I've committed to read as advanced reader copies, things like that. So for me, I have found that adding TBRs to my life a little bit has been really helpful. And I am somebody who just really enjoys challenges here on BookTube. Like, I enjoy watching them and I have a lot of fun filming them. They're not even really the most popular videos on my channel, but like, it kind of doesn't matter because I enjoy doing them, and I have to have things that I enjoy about the channel or else it's not worth doing. Like, this is my hobby. So all that to say, as a disclaimer, and I guess somewhat substantively starting to get into some of the points I want to make, I get that some people think TBRs are dumb and challenges are dumb or whatever. If that's you, okay, that's fine. That's you. I enjoy them. They have been helpful to me. And there we go. I get that not everybody likes it. I hope you can respect that some people do like doing that. So with that being said, I want to talk about, I guess, like my anti-TBR and why I've decided that like I'm for the summer putting aside some of my reading plans. So like, one of the main things that was making me realize that maybe I needed to rethink my game plan for the year is my 20 books that I want to read in 2020 list. This was a list I set at the end of last year for myself of 20 books that I wanted to read in 2020. But, and most, like, the big theme of that list are books that have been on my TBR for a very long time. So I wanted to get to them this year because, you know, they've been there a long time and at some point you gotta kind of put up or shut up. And so I was like, okay, this is great. These are 20 books that if I don't make a plan to get to them, they just keep not happening. So I had that. And then I also did my 12 classics I want to read in 2020. So I knew I was going to do that. Then I got the idea to do Operation Sci-Fi, which I really like got excited about and wanted to do. And so that was another challenge I was adding to my list for the year. Then I decided I wanted to do a finish up of the Immortals After Dark series and make that a project. So I did that. And then I decided I wanted to try some books, first books in some classic fantasy series. So I did that. And then last month I did a You Guys Pick My TBR challenge. Like I found myself adding a lot of like, not entire year projects, but like shorter term projects. That has meant that I have been accumulating a lot of challenges, which means that instead of having what I think is probably a better balance for me of like 50% TBR or challenge related books in a month versus 50% mood reading, I've gotten to the point where between all of those things that I had planned and arcs that I need to read, I would say 90% of what I'm reading now comes from a challenge of some kind. And I think that in a different year and under different circumstances, maybe that would be okay. But it has started to make me feel a little, it's just started to not feel quite like how I want to approach my reading this year, because this year has just been bananas. Like there's like the worldwide stuff that's going on that we're all experiencing in terms of quarantine and in terms of everything, all the unrest that is happening right now. And just like generally a lot of bigger picture things that I know are stressful for everyone. Personally, I've also had a tornado hit my neighborhood like a half mile from my house. Then I got some new cats, and then I had emergency surgery, which I am still recovering from. So that really threw off all of my reading plans in March and April. And actually, I pretty much caught back up on most of the challenges I was working on, with the exception of the 20 books I want to read in 2020. And that challenge has become almost like an albatross around my neck. I just feel like I know I'm behind in it. I keep trying to make plans of like, okay, this month I need to read like 5 books and then I can, you know, really be caught back up and be on track to finish all 20 books by the end of the year. I keep like trying to do that and keep not being successful at it because of all these other things that I want to do. And I think kind of where I've landed is it's not that I'm totally throwing out any of that planning, but I think I just like had to tell myself, and I know some people don't care about this and like don't actually follow what challenges I've set for myself. Like I know most of you don't, but I know, and I'm very like, once I decide I'm gonna do something, I do it. Like that is just part of my personality. And it has been very hard for me to be like, I decided I was gonna do this and I am not on track to do it. What this conversation is about and just generally where I'm trying to come from now is saying like, these are not 20 books that I have to read in 2020. These are now 20 books that I hope I will read in 2020. I already put some grace in there in my classics list. Like when I set that up, it's not 12 classics I'm going to read in 2020. It's 12 classics I hope I will get to 6 of in 2020. And I think I just need to have more of that approach with more of my challenges. And therefore, I have just declared this summer is the summer of getting much, like, much, much closer to having the balance back in my reading. So, will there be things that I have to read still? Yes. Like, Before We Were Yours by Lisa Wingate. I have to read this for book club that I'm in. So I'm gonna read this. So like, yes, I have that. I also have some books still in my Operation Sci-Fi challenge that I'm hoping I'm gonna read this summer, but I feel excited about that. Like that's a challenge that still feels fun and fresh to me and doesn't feel like a burden. So like, I'm gonna probably still read these 2 books this month and that's okay. Like that's a book I have to read, but it's one I'm more excited about. So I'm okay with it. I have arcs that I've committed to read for books that I'm really excited about. And so like, those are things that I have to read that I will still continue to get to. But I also have a lot of things that I'm now thinking about reading that don't have anything to do with the challenges that I made at the beginning of the year and are much more just about sort of mood reading. I decided 2 days ago that I was in the mood to do a challenge, which was reading like another booktuber. So I have started doing that and I'm really excited about it. And it's filled with books that are very conducive to mood reading. And so that's something I'm gonna work on this summer. You will see it. I think it's gonna be really fun. So like, I've chosen that that's something I'm gonna do. But you know, most of everything else I'm gonna read, I've just decided is gonna be mood reading. So like sequels that I keep meaning to get to and not making time for, like Deathless Divide or Dragon Shadow. Like, let's read these maybe. Who knows? Maybe I'll be in the mood for that. If I want to read more in a series that I started and was really excited about, I'm going to do it. If I want to start a new spinoff series, even though the initial hype for this is probably died down, who cares? I want to read this at some point because I love the Book of the Ancestors, so hopefully I will get a chance to read the first book in a spinoff series. But maybe not. That's also fine. Or new releases that came out last year that I was excited about but just never made time for. I could read that, or new releases that came out this year that I am excited for that I've just not gotten to. I can read whatever new releases. I guess this is technically not a new release anymore, but I can, you know, get to some of the things I pre-ordered and just haven't made time for yet. I can make time for arcs that I didn't ask for, but sound like fun, because I love Jill Chalvez. And even though I didn't ask for this, this looks like fun. I can make time for books that I've seen so much hype for on BookTube that I just keep not getting to, like Empire of Sand by Tasha Suri, which my friend Jocelyn at Yogi with a Book is obsessed with. And I would like to get to at some point, but I never do it because it's a little bigger. I mean, it's not huge, but you know, it's gonna take a little more time. And it's just hard for me to slot in because so many of my plans have been so structured that I just never really have enough time to get to this. Or I can just get to random ass books that have like some kind of hype around them. Like I've heard so many good things about The Widow of Rose House and I just keep not reading it because it doesn't fit into like a specific plan I have, which I think, you know, it's some of these more romancy things are a little easier for me to slot in, but if I don't have a specific reason to get to them, sometimes it just doesn't happen. Another challenge that I've decided I do want to do just because it's fun and very free form, and I am not going to make pressure to like pick books for this, but more just like serendipitously allow what I'm reading to count on the bingo card, is the Rip Bodice's summer romance bingo card that they make every year. I'm gonna do that because it just seems like fun. And whatever random romances I end up reading that fit in, cool. We'll see how many bingos I can get. But you know, other just random books that I've heard are good, like A Good Girl's Guide to Murder. I saw one of my favorite YA mystery authors, Jennifer Lynn Barnes, said that if you like the Natural series, which I love that she wrote, that you should read A Good Girl's Guide to Murder. So like, this doesn't fit into anything, but I wanna read it. So maybe I'll make time to do that. Or I keep talking about doing a reread of the Psy Changeling series and I freaking love this new book. And I could reread this like two times and be happy. So maybe one thing I'm thinking about doing is rereading all of the Psy Changeling books that I really like. I mean, some of them are not my favorites, but like, I don't know, A Slave to Sensation and Caressed by Ice and Kiss of Snow, like some of the highlights of the series. If I want to make time to reread them, I can. That's fine. Basically, you're watching me yell at myself because I hate that I put myself in the position of choices that I made in 2019 before we knew what the hell was going to happen in 2020 are dictating what I'm reading so much. So like, this is my anti-TBR of like, I am going to still read things that I have committed to read in terms of arcs. And I still have a couple of challenges that still sound like fun to me and I have energy for right now, and I'm going to do that. But all other reading plans for the summer, I just feel like I have so many things. I have all the books. I want to read them all. And you know, I've been reading a lot of like some of the kind of more non-fiction-y things that have been on my TBR for a while that are really relevant to this current moment. And I want to allow myself to have space for that and not feel like it's taking away from other plans that I have. You know what? None of us planned for what was gonna happen in 2020. 2019 me didn't fully understand what life was going to look like. So I know that most of you are not that invested in my preset lists. This is me talking to my Virgo moon / Enneagram one who wants to do things the right way. Like I am trying to just like tell myself that for the summer till Labor Day, I can just allow myself to mood read a lot more. And the plan is there's much less of a plan than there was, is kind of the bottom line. So I will not be focused on getting to the 20 books I want to read in 2020 this summer. If I happen, I know you've been hearing my kitties playing in the background and now we've got the bird noise. I know that I am the one who is invested in these more than you guys, but you know, if I don't get to them this summer, it's okay. The plan is there is no plan aside from the plans that I still like. For whatever that's worth, that's the course that I am charting as of right now. I'm gonna wrap up this like chatty rant about my own anal retentiveness about my reading plans here, I guess, because my cats are feeling very frisky and if you've not been hearing all the noise that they're making, I think that that will continue. So I'm gonna wrap this up here. I'd be curious to hear from you guys. Like, how do you think about TBRs? Are you strictly a mood reader? Are you someone who likes challenges? Let me know kind of how you approach structuring or not structuring your reading. And if the comment you have is TBRs are dumb, why are you doing this to yourself? Like, I've already heard that comment and you just don't need to leave it. but I think some people probably can relate to this. So I thought I would just share my own like throwing in the towel anti-TBR-ness of the rest of the summer. So that's where I'm at. I hope you guys enjoyed this random rambly video. If you did, please like, subscribe, follow me on the social medias if you are so inclined. I have all that information listed in the description box below, and I think that that will do it. I hope you're having an absolutely lovely day today, and I will just talk to you soon. Bye.